Oh dang, a spite list not about Harley Davidson? Huh, never thought I'd see the day. Yes, I do in fact think about things other than Harley Davidson, even though Yam is quick to remind me that I always bring up buying one whenever we shoot our podcasts. Today we're going to take a few minutes and talk about the best bikes to buy used. Now that the riding season is upon us, a lot of people will be looking to start riding, or maybe they're thinking about adding another bike to the stable, and unless you're looking to light a big old pile of money on fire, you're probably not going to be grabbing two brand spanking new motorcycles. Instead, you're probably going to be looking to save a little bit on a used bike that's a good juxtaposition against your daily rider, maybe a dirt bike or a cruiser or even a track toy. Well, to help you out, I've spent an afternoon meditating on the best motorcycles to buy used, meaning that it's actually better for you to buy them secondhand than fresh off the showroom floor. And I know it might sound a little strange. I mean, what's better than taking that first ride on a brand new 1 mile bike and bringing it home for the very first time? But bear with me, maybe you can save a little bit of money. I also threw in a few bikes that you should definitely not buy, used or otherwise, just to give you a little bit of variety. Before we jump in though, I need to shout out today's sponsor, Rockform. They're a new partner for the channel and they make the best phone case and handlebar mount combo for your bike. Gone are the days of having some big claw that holds your phone on your two-wheeled land missile using nothing more than friction and rubber bands. I mean, come on, can you even see your instrument cluster behind that big old thing? Rockform is the better way to go. Simply bolt the slim mount to your handlebars, pop the drop-tested case on your phone, twist it on, and go. The case even has a phone-safe magnet so you can mount your phone anywhere on your bike so you can watch a tutorial on changing the oil while you do it. No more oil prints on your fancy new phone screen. Man, that would have come in handy when I was wrenching on the DRZ last night. Right now, fans of the Yam can get 25% off your order using the code YN25. Click the link below and get yours today. Now, some rules for today's list. Number one, we're talking about classes or styles of bikes, not specific bikes, but with one exception. Two, bikes must be owned by average Joes, so no crazy ADV Boosas or 52-inch front tire baggers or whatever you normally see in Cleveland. Number three, we aren't going to be talking too much about price, but you can assume they're anywhere from like $1,500 to $12,000, depending on the bike. Coming in at number seven on today's list of bikes to buy used, it's track bikes.
Spite STFU, you don't know anything about track riding.
No, I don't, and I'll freely admit that. It's basically just a bunch of dudes in gym suits going around in circles all day, right? So, just the Indy 500? Well, you don't need to be Mark Marquez to know it's a waste of money to run out and buy an R1 for $20,000 just to dump another 5 to 10 into it just to track prep it. All I hear Yam talk about when he's not fawning over his Daytona is how much of a pain in the ass it was to track prep the thing. Between fairings, suspension, levers, windscreens, frame sliders, exhausts, tunes, it's a gigantic headache, so why not let some other poor schlub do all the hard work and just buy his old track weapon? Sure, it won't be set up for you, but that'll take a few key tweaks and you'll be 90% of the way there. If you hang around a track often enough, you'll hear some regular talking about how he's getting ready to sell his current steed for a bigger and better one. I mean, I've spent all of one day at a track and I heard it no less than 5 times from different people. You can usually get a pretty good deal too, since you know that a track prepped bike hasn't exactly been babied and mods don't add value. Number 6 is your first bike, and this is a point that we've made a lot on the channel, but it's not exactly the best idea to buy your first motorcycle brand new. Don't get me wrong, a lot of people do, and I'm sure they're sounding off in the comments, but for the average rider, it makes a lot more sense to buy a used bike that's had some miles put down on it. Not only will it be cheaper than a new bike, but when you drop it, you won't feel as bad since it's not some shiny new bike that you've dumped your life savings into or took out a nice $10,000 loan at 17% interest. Buying your first bike is something you should probably do towards the end of the riding season or in the winter, since people aren't riding them and they're usually willing to let them go for a nice price. Plus, the aftermarket tends to have way more options for you. You can't get a Ninja 250 at a dealership, but I saw an immaculate one going for $1,800 on Craigslist. There's other bikes like the Ninja 500, the Rebel 250s, or KLR 650s that are all out of production that you can score for cheap online, and all would make for excellent first bikes. Number 5. Dirt bikes. For the life of me, I don't get why dirt bikes are even sold new. I mean, sure, every now and again someone manages to total a dirt bike, but my understanding is generally they're unkillable. It's in that spirit that I suggest skipping the new dirt bike and going for a used one. The Austin Craigslist is lousy with people trying to offload their CRFs, KLXs, and ZYJ6E31S. That's either what KTM calls their dirt bikes, or it's the name of Elon Musk's kid. But seriously, It's kind of a pain to try and find a road-legal dual sport in our market because there's just so many off-road bikes up for grabs. And in a world where you have so many choices, it's a buyer's market. Do you want to spend $9,000 on a shiny new dirt bike or spend $5,000 on one that's seen a few hours but is basically the exact same bike? I'd recommend buying one that's a little on the nicer side since a lot of people tend to treat dirt bikes like rented mules, so keep an eye out for detailed service records. Bonus points to a dirt bike that has already had some of the head work done. I know a lot of competition off-road bikes have super tight service intervals and often require parts of the engine to be rebuilt after so many hours. So if you want to keep your costs down, skim through the ad and see what's been done to the bike, then cross-reference it with what the factory service interval and then cross-reference it with what the factory service interval and then cross-reference it with what the factory service interval
bleh, ah, f**k.
And then cross-reference nope and then cross-reference that with what the factory service intervals are. Moving on, number 4 is bikes with exhausts. Now this one's kind of a tough one given that everyone has their own preferences when it comes to exhaust sounds, but buying a motorcycle that already has an exhaust on it is a great way to save yourself anywhere from $300 to $1,700 in parts. Pretty much every motorcycle in the used market has an exhaust system installed on it already, but if you're looking at two of the same bike, one stock and one with a pipe, I'd recommend just going with the modded one. Not only is it going to be cheaper for you, but looking at how the pipe was installed can tell you a lot about the owner. Did they go slow and do the job right, or are there a bunch of stripped and mismatching bolts on the pipe and a bunch of dings and dents? If the exhaust was competently installed, you can infer that the maintenance on the bike was also competently done. It's not a catch-all though, given how easy exhausts are to install, but this doesn't just go for exhausts. It can apply to any mod. If you have some specific idea of what you want your bike to look like, it might be worth it to just find one that's as close to your end goal as possible so you spend more time riding and less time wrenching. Bonus points here for bikes that are already tuned since fuel tuners are expensive and a pain in the butt to install in some cases. Number 3, Harley Davidsons. Yup, I had to do it to you. You know I wasn't gonna put together a list without mentioning everyone's favorite, least favorite brand, Harley Davidson. But honestly, a Harley makes a whole lot more sense to buy used than brand spanking new. Not only are you gonna save a boatload on the ticket price, but in the used market, they can often hold their price fairly well. If you buy a beater and fix it up, it's an easy way to make a little bit of money. Also, if you go back to the pre-2007 bikes, you can find great deals on carbed Harleys. These bikes will always come modded, so you're sure to save a little money on exhaust, probably a seat, and in some cases, you might even find a bike with some of the engine work done to make more power. Just remember, mods don't add value, so don't let the seller do some voodoo magic on you because he has the complete Screamin' Eagle twin cam freedom cannons with a high velocity spark plugs and matching Screamin' Eagle spark plug wires. If he's poured $5,000 into the bike in terms of mods, it's still only gonna sell for around blue books, so take advantage. Number 2, small displacement motorcycles. But Spite, you already mentioned beginner bikes. And yeah, small displacement bikes usually are beginner bikes, but what if you already have a cruiser and want to add a smaller sport bike to your stable? Then hit the classifieds and grab yourself a Ninja 400 for pennies on the dollar. Like dirt bikes, small displacement motorcycles are everywhere in the used market because people buy them and grow out of them in a season or two. They might have had a million different owners, but a well-maintained second-hand little bike is basically exactly the same as a brand new one, just several grand cheaper. The beauty here is these bikes always have a fairly high minimum value, which is why you see wretched 250s still selling for $1,500 or more. So buy one, beat the snot out of it, and sell it to some kid who just got his license next year for basically the same price you bought it for. Finally, number 1 are SV650s. This is the exception to my rule, but the SV650 is so ubiquitous and so easy to come by used that it makes no sense to buy a new one. Whether you want one as a commuter, a track bike, or just a weekend ride, just go get a used one. They're basically unkillable, really well built, and if you're willing to buy a bit of a black sheep, Gladii, whatever. They're basically the same thing, just $1,000 cheaper because Ari Hennings said they were ugly that one time. And hey, if you want an SV650, we're actually giving one away for free over on YammyNoob.co. What beats a bike you got for a great deal? One you didn't have to pay a dime for. But before I sign off, I wanted to give you a few bikes you should absolutely not buy used, just in case you were planning on making a huge mistake. Think of this as a list within a list. Our first entry on the dishonorable mentions list are these absolutely crusty shit bikes you see on Craigslist. They are just not worth it. You might get a good deal on one out the door because some poor sap bought a lemon and didn't have the time or patience to get it running, but one of two things is gonna happen. Either you're gonna spend way more money than the motorcycle is worth to fix it, or you're just gonna get bored and sell it again for even less money. When you factor in the cost of the bike and the repairs, it might even come out to be more expensive to fix it up. Ask me how I know. At least my DRZ's running again. Trust me, it sucks to own a motorcycle you can't ride, so do yourself a favor and give the Craigslist specials a miss. Second in our mini list here are the takeover payment bikes. You know what I mean. The ad'll read something like this. I bought this bike one day and the wife said that if I kept it, she was gonna murder me in my sleep, so I need someone to take over payments on the bike. Usually this is accompanied with basically a brand new motorcycle that has fewer than 1,000 miles on it. They crop up most often at the beginning of the riding season because people get really gung-ho around then. Here's the thing. If you know the person who's quote-unquote selling the motorcycle, and I use the word selling loosely, then it can work, but it's more trouble than it's worth. Remember, if they don't have the title to the bike, they don't actually own it, so save a little bit more and keep looking. Lastly, salvage titles. Never, ever buy a salvage title bike. I know people down below will be all, well, I bought a salvage title motorcycle and it runs great. It's cheaper to insure too, but there's a reason they're cheaper. You often can't get the same level of coverage on a salvage title as you could with a clean title bike. Unfortunately, this applies to those Panigales you see on Crash Toys going for $1,000 with just scuffed fairings too. Also, who knows how well the repairs were done? It's entirely likely that it was some 10-thumbed, half-drunk mechanic who managed to get it inspected right before quitting time on Friday and it squeaked through the cracks. Sure, they might make for a good cheap track bike, but for most people, it's way better to just get a clean title bike.
Ah, so real bummer, this video is actually over, but you're in luck. There are hundreds of other Yami Noob videos you can go and check out. Hit this one right over here. Watch it. Do it for Yami-chan.